In the midst of the current COVID-19 outbreak, there's been plenty of chatter about historical pandemics like the Black Plague and the 1918 Spanish flu outbreak. But one outbreak from recent memory is being compared to COVID-19 more than any other, the H1N1 swine flu pandemic of 2009. So, COVID-19 versus H1N1 swine flu, which is worse? First of all, it's worth pointing out that this is an ongoing outbreak and that the situation is changing by the minute. The information on this video is accurate as of March 2020, but this outbreak is far from over. And as we learn more about COVID-19, things will undoubtedly change. In fact, they'll probably change by the time you finish this video. Now that we've got that out of the way, let's take a look at how the current COVID-19 outbreak stacks up against the 2009 H1N1 swine flu pandemic. It makes sense that we're looking back to the H1N1 swine flu pandemic for clues about what the current COVID-19 outbreak has in store for us. The H1N1 swine flu outbreak was the last most recent global pandemic, and it shares many things in common with COVID-19, including similar symptoms and global spread. Although looking to the past can be useful, it's important to remember that no two pandemics are the same. While there's currently a lot we can learn by looking at the commonalities between the two outbreaks, it can be dangerous to base too much of our actions in the present on things that happened in the past without understanding the key differences. Both the current COVID-19 outbreak and the 2009 H1N1 swine flu pandemic were caused by viruses. A virus is a tiny microorganism that reproduces by inserting its genetic material into host cells, causing those cells to burst and die or become malignant. There are many different kinds of viruses, and they can mutate and change over time. And each virus causes different symptoms as it attacks our cells and our body tries to fight off the infection. The swine flu was an aggressive strain of the flu virus called H1N1 that infects the cells that line our respiratory tract. The outbreak was called the swine flu because this particular virus had been known to cause illnesses in pigs, but the 2009 pandemic was the first time this virus was known to infect humans. The outbreak started in the US in April 2009 and quickly spread across the globe. Less than 2 weeks after the first confirmed case in California, the World Health Organization had declared a public health emergency that lasted until August 2010. The COVID-19 outbreak emerged in Wuhan, China in late 2019 before quickly spreading to other countries. The COVID-19 disease is caused by a virus called Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome, Coronavirus 2, or SARS-CoV-2. Like the swine flu, this virus that causes COVID-19 can likely be tracked back to animals, but scientists are trying to work out exactly how it made the jump to humans. While the H1N1 and COVID-19 viruses are similar in some ways, they actually belong to different virus groups. H1N1 is an influenza virus, but COVID-19 is from the coronavirus family and is more likely an extremely contagious viral pneumonia. H1N1 viruses have a long history of past outbreaks, more on that in a bit, but COVID-19 is a novel virus, one that has never before been seen in humans, making it tricky to look to the past for clues about the severity or duration of the outbreak. The fact that the swine flu and COVID-19 viruses are from different virus groups also accounts for the different symptoms experienced by those who contract the viruses. There's some overlap. Fever, cough, and a sore throat are common symptoms of both swine flu and COVID-19. But there are many key differences. H1N1 swine flu symptoms typically resemble flu symptoms, fever and chills, body aches, and fatigue. We're still investigating all the symptoms of COVID-19, but a fever and cough seem to be the most common. Other symptoms include headache, sore throat, abdominal pain, and diarrhea. Complications from both viruses can include respiratory illness like pneumonia, which can be serious or even fatal. A major difference between swine flu and COVID-19 is how long it takes for symptoms to show up in the first place. Swine flu symptoms usually start within 1 to 4 days of contracting the virus, but COVID-19 is much sneakier. It can be up to 2 weeks before the symptoms appear, if they show up at all. Some people infected with the virus are asymptomatic, which is bad news when it comes to containing its spread. Viruses are spread through contact with infected people or surfaces. When a person with a virus coughs or sneezes, they release respiratory droplets that can be inhaled by someone nearby or end up on nearby surfaces or hands. Both H1N1 swine flu and COVID-19 can spread through these respiratory droplets, which can make their way to your mouth, nose, or eyes when you touch your face after touching an infected surface. Recent evidence suggests that the COVID-19 virus can live on surfaces like cardboard for 24 hours, steel for 48 hours, and plastic for 72 hours. Some viruses, like the H1N1 swine flu virus, can also be airborne. When people cough or sneeze or even breathe, they emit small particles called aerosols. These particles may contain the virus, and they can float in the air for a while before being inhaled, allowing the virus to spread through the air. Thankfully, so far, WHO has said there are no reports of aerosolized transmission of COVID-19. Even so, COVID-19 appears to be more contagious than H1N1 swine flu. So how do we measure the contagiousness of a virus? As an infection spreads to new people, it reproduces itself. The reproduction number, or R0 value, is a measure of how contagious a disease is. H1N1 swine flu had an R0 value of 1.46, meaning each person who contracted the virus spread it to an average of 1.46 other people. Based on early data, COVID-19 has an R0 value between 2 to 2.5, which is even more unsettling when we know that not everyone with the virus shows symptoms. So, who is more at risk when it comes to these viruses? In both cases, as with any viral outbreak, those with underlying health issues are the most at risk. People with compromised immune systems, like cancer patients, have a hard time fighting off a new infection and are more prone to experiencing complications if they are exposed to the virus. Elderly people can also be at a high risk. In most pandemics, the death rate is heavily stacked against older people, and this does seem to be the case with COVID-19 so far. In a typical year, between 70 and 90% of all flu-related deaths are over the age of 65. One of the things that's made the H1N1 swine flu outbreak so unique was the fact that up to 80% of the people who died during the swine flu outbreak were under the age of 65. Researchers were able to determine that approximately one-third of all people over the age of 60 had immunity to swine flu thanks to the presence of antibodies in their system. This was likely because they had been exposed to a similar strain of H1N1 earlier in their lives. In fact, the infamous Spanish flu was caused by an H1N1 virus. Very few people under 60 had these antibodies, hence the much higher than normal death rate in the under 60 population. If these older people hadn't been immune, the H1N1 swine flu pandemic could have been much worse. COVID-19, on the other hand, is a novel virus, which means we've never seen any evidence of it in people before now. This also means that no one has immunity against it since their body hasn't produced antibodies against it. When we talk about COVID-19 versus H1N1 swine flu, what we're often really getting at is which is deadlier. A decade after the outbreak, we have some clear data about H1N1 swine flu. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, H1N1 swine flu infected 700 million to 1.4 billion people worldwide and killed between 151,000 and 575,000 people in the first year of the pandemic, up to 0.007% of the world's population. H1N1 had a case fatality rate of 0.02%. The case fatality rate is the proportion of people with a specific disease who will die from that disease over a specific time period. It's a measurement that can be used to track the severity of a disease and the effectiveness of treatments. With COVID-19, it's too early to say with any accuracy what the final case fatality rates will be. There are estimates based on current data, but those numbers will be skewed because we don't yet know the outcome of all the current cases, and it's hard to get an accurate case count in the first place. As of March 21, 2020, WHO has reported 292,000 total cases so far. Of those cases, there have been 12,700 deaths to date, which works out to a case fatality rate of 0.04%. Though experts estimate that the final case fatality rate for COVID-19 could be anywhere between 0.25% to 3%. Just to put those numbers in context, the 1918 Spanish flu infected 500 million people, or a third of the world's population, and killed up to 50 million at a time when our understanding of viruses and social distancing were pretty limited, to say the least. Another huge difference between the H1N1 swine flu of 2009 and the current COVID-19 outbreak is that this is the first true pandemic of the social media age, when stories can spread faster than a virus. Sure, Facebook and Twitter were around back in 2009, but they weren't anywhere near as popular as they are now. But that doesn't mean people were immune to the kind of panic that we're currently experiencing. Robert Thompson, a professor of media and popular culture at Syracuse University in New York, was quoted at the time as saying, "If as many people had swine flu as those who are covering swine flu, then it would be a pandemic to reckon with." Early news coverage was non-stop until the pandemic story was eventually knocked out of the headlines by a political scandal. So, COVID-19 versus H1N1 swine flu, which is worse? Well, unfortunately, it's too soon to say for certain. Remember, the COVID-19 outbreak is still ongoing, and although this information is accurate as of March 2020, new information is coming in by the hour, so the situation could very well change. No two pandemics are the same, so when we're comparing COVID-19 to H1N1 swine flu or to any other pandemic, we should be focusing on understanding how to best respond to these types of emergencies now and in the future, not on trying to predict the future of this particular pandemic. The H1N1 swine flu pandemic turned out to be not as bad as originally predicted, but experts caution against assuming that COVID-19 will be the same. H1N1's ability to spread might have been limited because the older population was largely immune to the virus. Young people shouldn't assume they're safe, although older people seem to be at a higher risk for COVID-19. There's plenty of evidence of severe and even fatal cases in young, otherwise healthy individuals. At this point, COVID-19 doesn't appear to be airborne like swine flu was, but it is more contagious than H1N1 and can take longer for symptoms to show up. As far as how bad things might get, a lot will depend on how we as a global society respond to the threat. You can do your part to help stop the spread of COVID-19 by covering your mouth when you cough or sneeze, washing your hands, disinfecting surfaces, and maintaining social distancing of at least 2 meters or 6 feet. If you've been traveling, or especially if you're feeling sick, well, it should go without saying that you should not be running to the grocery store, let alone going to work or visiting grandma at the nursing home. Stay home, limit your contact with others, and contact your doctor or local health authority right away. Even if you don't feel sick or aren't worried about your own health, staying home as much as possible is the best way to stop the virus from spreading. Remember, you could be contagious even if you don't have any symptoms. Stay at home, not just for your own sake, but for everyone. It's how we'll beat the virus. While you're stuck inside, we've got you covered. If you found this video informative, you'll want to check out this other video called The Most Effective Way to Kill a Virus. Or perhaps you'll like this other video instead. And as always, thanks for watching, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.